It doesn't make that. The organizer and its agencies reserve the right to use the entry's name and the materials for the purpose of publicity, advertising, and or promotion without prior compensation or notice. The organizer reserves the right to cancel, change, or amend this contest and its rules and regulations. And finally, the decision of the Board of Judges is final. Thank you.
We want a continuation of Direct Mario's vision, which is why we're asking Ms. Raquel and the Vicencio to be part of the selection committee.
May nasasabi po si Mr. Joel Romero.
We may have an addition to the selection committee. Last time there were three, and we're expecting to receive more entries this year. So we're considering having four members of the selection committee this year.
Tanong lang Direct Joey, ano? Doon sa guidelines, tumalabas na kailangan tumakalipay ito sa MDRCP, ano? Kasi ang, if I'm not mistaken, hindi dating mga ToFarm, parang tinulungan sila ng MDCP, so hindi sila dumaan sa MDRCP. So, hindi ba kabalikan dito ang MDCP sa MDRCP?
Ang rules kasi is pag government-sponsored ang pelikula, they can get an exemption from MDRCP. Since ToFarm is not a government project, it will still have to pass through MDRCP. And that's a lot of it sa regular theaters, not like the other festivals that contain things like Sinmalaya and cultural center of the Philippines.
Mrs. Sao, tatanong ko lang po regarding yung ownership ng sa rights ng pelikula. Ano ba maging agreement nito?
The ownership of the rights for the future film competition will be 50-50. The farm will own 50% of the movie and the director will own 50% of the other 50%.
Pero when it comes to the holding period, kasi di ba they are allowed to get financiers or fund ng kanilang production. So ano yung holding period yung means na ito ay ToFarm?
Ang plano kasi ng ToFarm doon right now is just that the first money position in when we talk of ROI belongs to ToFarm. After that, yung the other co-producer already.
Last question po, kasi nasabi ni Direk Mario J. De Los Reyes last year sa festival na possible magkaroon ng section part ng documentary. Ano po ang status nito ngayon?
still being studied because akin muna natin na yung short film competition, which as Direct Joey was explaining kanina, the short film competition is open to all amateur filmmakers. The length of the film is 1 minute, not less than 1 minute, no more than 10 minutes, and with it covering the theme, a slice of life, eto na, vignettes in the life of people related to agricultural concerns.
This year, ba magkakaroon ng director ko ng mga pelikula na direct partner?
We're trying, we're working to get a good copy of Magnifico to be the opening film of ToFarm. And last week we talked already to the owners of Magnifico, the family of Madame Violet Sevilla. Sinugan na sila ng 2010. And sinugan na bakit nila shortly before nakuha ni Greg Mario yung print na hindi niya. However, upon conversation with Manette David of Central Digital, who merong nakuha the rights of Magnifico airing on cable TV now belong to ABS-CBN. So, they have a good copy, pero for TV. So, Ms. David says that pwede namang i-transfer to a good MP4 version for showing on an LED. So, we would very much like to follow that up and make sure that it gets shown, and if it gets to be shown, it will be courtesy of ABS-CBN and Madam Violet Sevilla.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you, Lam.
Hey, Doctor Ahaw. Nakausap namin si Direk Mario January 30 sa Virginia sa virtual event. Natutuwa siya mo na inisipan mong ituloy itong ToFarm this year. Kasi ang plano ko raw sana doon, wala ko na this year para matigyan ng ibang mga pelikula sa itong market. Pero naisipan mo maghanap pa rin this year.
Can I say something?
Yes.
Actually, siya yung nagsabi na market mo na namin.
Yes.
Sabi ko, sandali, parang malungkot ako ah. Sabi ko. So, noong December, bago matapos yung taon, so ko, direct mo na-announce, sabi ko, hindi mo na ako. Then, tapos ng New Year's Eve, ay ko, hindi ba? So, direct, tuloy na natin, sabi ko.
Kaya nga natutuwa siya na excited kayo na pero hindi siya. Na parang ang plano pa yata niya yun noon, dati July ito ginagawa. Dahil medyo kulang sa preparasyon, dapat November sana. Pero ngayon parang napaaga September. Hindi ba kayo sa oras, sa panahon, magagawa
ko? Ano ko pa sasagutin yan?
Pero yung mga nagagawa kasi pala naman noon.
Actually, medyo late na nga kami yata eh, pero hindi namin sinabay sa ibang film festival. Yun ang purpose namin. Kasi tingin namin kung tama ba yan. Yung ibang kasi yung katulad ng Cinemaraya, saka bakit ito yung mga schedule na sila, so hindi kami sumabay. Yun ang reason, pati naging September.
Saka siyempre yung mga kaibigan ni Greg Mario, makasala na si Dr. Hao, magaling pagkilala din sa kanya, sa pagpapahalaga.
Yeah, sobrang madaling ka-deal si Direk Mario. Wala kami yung problema sa isa't isa. Almost every meeting namin, Emma, we end up in accord. Yeah, we agree on almost everything. Yeah, so no problem.
Hey, Direct Event. Ano yung pakiramdam mo? Parang may pressure ba sa'yo na ikaw kayo pumalit kay Direct Mario? Expectations sa iyo?
Even in our first set of meetings, we avoided using the word replacing Direct Mario because the man is hard to replace. I'm stepping into really big shoes here. So I'd rather not say that I'm replacing him, but I'm not also taking his place. I will just be festival director. Sabi nga nga, mahal namin lahat na si Itay Baliday, the original is best. And with that, that's it.
Thank you.
It's nothing but the truth.
Do we have more questions? Ayan, wag po tayong kaya lumapit sa ating mic. It's at the center po. Then I would like to give emphasis po dun sa sinabi ko kanina. The main theme for this year is tribute to life. Para din na. Yung nga, nabagin ka din na ni Direk na slice of life. Yan, yan po ang ating main theme para sa mga nagsasubmit. Ito din ang mga konsepto for this year.
Yeah, he says that for the feature film competition, it's tribute to life para din na. For the short film competition, it's a slice of life.
Alright.
Yeah. Oh, we were also thinking in terms kasi of the length of the short films.
Okay, thank you, Bonere. Questions po from the press? Okay. Baka po yung mga nasa likod, you have questions? Or you want to raise your hand, abutan po namin kayo ng mikropono. There, I have my see hands at the back. Sige po.
Excuse me. Nalimutan banggitin na very important. Ito na to, mami, sinamin na nalimutan namin. Okay, so this year we're going to produce 7 ToFarm films. That is under with the advocacy, with the team of that advocacy to our farmers, no? So hindi lang siya farmers kundi all those in the agri sector, no? So that means hindi naman exactly magsasaka lang, pwede mangingisda, pwedeng ano pa ba yung iba, yung sa livestock, no? Basta so, yung mga tabang pang agriculture, no? Okay. Bukod doon, meron kami din produce this year na 6 films.
Six commercial films. Dr. Hao is also going to establish Universal Harvester Films. So that's going to be outside of ToFarm Film Festival. There will be another 6 films that will try to introduce into the commercial industry market.
May konti akong gusto i-share sa inyo kasi I'm sure tignan nyo sa inyong mga business case, no? Baka, just like to let you know that of the 12 films that we have produced this first 2 years, we have several films that have won international awards. Can you show that? Sunny? Sunny, pwede ba? Ngayon na? Sige, please na. Okay, baka ka-uwi sila, hindi nila makita yun.
Hindi kayo ako magkaibig.
Sorry, maliit yung screen namin eh. Marami pa yan eh.
Lumiit na po yung court kasi ang dami po nating awards na nakapunta. Hi, Kai! Instalado?
At marami pang awards na dumadating kasi yung iba tuloy-tuloy pa yung mga international film festival sa ibang bansa. We like you to know na most of our films eh, hindi masyadong kilala nito, pero sa internationally, yung mga film festival na nila na nagkaroon ng nominations, marami ang napanalo na namin, no? At we look forward to continuously having films produced by our brilliant directors na continue naman nanalo pa, no? At so, alam nyo, medyo malungkot ako na mga films dito hindi masyadong napapalabas dito kasi hindi namin mapalabas sa mga movie houses, no? kasi namimidiya pa sila na mas malakas mabenta. Kaya gagawa na kami ng commercial business para mayroon yung kanilang alabas doon. Kasi, no? Para mayroon pa kami yung pang ano, may kami pang ang tawag doon. Ha?
Avenue, para mas marami na po makadaon.
But also to get there, we promise them to help. We are just going to go only into having screenplays written and movies produced, but we intend to also get into the matter of studying booking. We'll look into booking concerns. We'll look into strategy of film showing to maximize what can we maximize for our principal, Dr. Hao.
Actually, alam din ni Direct Mario, no? we have been discussing this already. So sabi niya, ganito yan, Lila, ganito yung gagawin natin. Meron tayong rom-com, meron tayong LGBT, no? Meron din tayong action comedy. Walang X-rated. Kung ano yung hinihingi ng masa, meron din kami. So, but we will preserve our ToFarm films kasi ito ay advocacy. So, hihiwalay namin yan. No? Kasi ayaw namin mawala sa aming program yun, sa continuously gagawin namin yun. At napaka-noble nitong mga ito. At nakita naman yun sa mga nananaro dyan. Nakita nyo, sa international film festivals, na-appreciate na yung ganyan mga film. So, talagang meron mga message, mga magaganda yung mga film. Sa kagawin, they have moral stories, moral values na pinapakita. So, like to continue doing that. Iiwala lang namin. Okay?
Pastor, remember when Dr. Hao first came to Joey and I, we were both struck and realized that her name was not a coincidence. The woman's name is Milagros, Mirabel. Family name is Hao. It's not why, it's not when, it's not what, it's not where, it's how. How do we do all these things that she wants us to do? That will be our challenge. But then again, we will abide by the fact that her first name is Milagros.
We feel how proud it is, si Doctora, sa mga achievements ng mga pelikula. Because more than that, it's just a festival. So far, it has become a family, right? Kasi hindi siya natatapos doon ang sa pagdaitan sa natin yung pelikula just by giving the awards. Hanggang ngayon, yung mga directors and writers are fully connected with the festival. So, talagang nararamdaman natin kung gaano ka-proud si Doctora sa achievements. At kaya ako na sinabi niya, the films hindi ko masyadong naipalabas dito sa Pilipinas, but it has gaining so much recognition abroad internationally. So, palampakan po natin yun.
Doctora, may tanong lang po sa table namin. No offense naman kay Bimet sa akin ganito siya. Pero bakit daw po silang dalawa ang napili yung magpatuloy, nireplace mo ba? Magpatuloy sa simulan, kinarap pa yung gender sex.
Pasasagot doon?
Opo.
Alam niyo, nag-interview na din ako ng, I have met other directors. And I found in them, I can see na magiging successful ang aming cooperation. Magdali silang kausap at we have mapipil mo agad kung magkakasundo tayo eh. Diba? Magkakasundo. So, malaking bagay yun eh. Pag yung kakausap ko, natatakot ako, baka hindi ko matanong isang question na yun, diyan mahilap na muna. So, kaya ko ma-explain, ma-sabi yung mga problema, and we meet together. So, very important.
Hello. Hello po. Sorry, talaga po.
Hello po. Congratulations, Ms. Lynette and Dr. Joe. Next step, hindi ko po alam po kung nasa price list yung sa usap nila first. Yung criteria for judging po, for the full net. Kasi sa April 29 deadline po, so syempre para sa mga nakakabasa ng future filmmakers namin, ano po ang kanilang dapat gawin para po mga pasok? Ano po yung mga criteria for judging?
Vision and craftsmanship. Vision and craftsmanship. The spine of the film must have to deal with the concerns of fisherman, the farmer, the livestock raiser. But yan lahat, nakasalalay, content dun sa craftsmanship, sa pagkakagawa. We felt that parang for us to say it outright this early, parang we felt that it was already went without saying. Na kailangan siya may saying. Parang ang superfluous kasi ilagay sa rules and regulations. A movie that is ugly will not be selected. Parang we felt that it's understood already. Na kailangan. May mukha yung pelikula, may forma, may sinasabi. Ako ba yan, Mel?
Yes, sir. Yes, Mr. Mel. Apo.
Nakatago po sa
sinasabi. And then, so, noted po yun. May partnership pa rin po ba ang ToFarm with SM Cinemas? Like the previous 2 years. At sa SM na po ba exclusively yung mga panood, mga pelikula?
Those details were all still in the process of putting together, the next press conference of ToFarm will be May 23, which is where we announce the finalists, and that's where we'll be giving out the details of kung saan papalabas, kung ang theaters ang nakausap namin for partnership. But we would like everything to be usapang sigurado na, kasi pangat naman we announce now and then we will be implementing.
During the past 2 years po, naging medyo challenge po sa festival na yung marketing and distribution. Napakapusahan nyo na po ba early right now yung
yes.
Plan po niyo?
Yes. As I said, Dr. Joe and I intend to also go into the matter of booking.
Okay.
Also study the matter of bringing the films all over to the various schools. Mm-hmm. It's being done now. And this year, we also have the emergence already of movie houses like Cinema Scenario, Cinema Cine 76, so lahat po yung pag-aaralan at ayos na. Because as I said, Dr. Joy and I have limitations to step into. And also to clarify, Dr. Joy and I do not entertain any illusions. We are not way saying that we are equal to what Fanny Pedestrians has done as a director, that we stand on even keel with him. There is a job on hand to be done to continue with the advocacy of Dr. Ma with regards to promoting the farmer. And that's what we intend to get into, and we hope that we will get to what Dr. Ma expects us to do.
Last question po, the same po ba ang cash prize as a winner sa feature level?
Yes.
Thank you. Congratulations, Ida.
Ano question for Dr. Pao? In the last 2 years that you've been holding the festival and with your farming advocacy, what has been the impact of the winners on the general consciousness, on farming, on the children of the farmer especially?
Impact on which one,
especially in your advocacy of farming, has there been any change in the mindset of the people about towards farming and farmers?
For one thing, we have shown this to a lot of farmers and continuously impact. We have a lot of requests for to show this film continuously. There's many institutions, Sunny, we have so many now, from from especially from universities, from schools, from Sunny, can you tell who are madami, you know? Continuously they napalabas pa siya. So of course yung mga friends kong partners, you know, in my business, I work close to the farmers. So every time I meet with them, and they're my number one guest. So kalat na kalat yung ano yung showing ng film sa countryside.
Do you think it just made a difference in the way the children of the farmers are looking at farming as a vocation or as a job, even as a job, and are they rethinking their former preference for working abroad as an OFW?
Honestly, to be honest, no, I don't want to make up my stories. You know, kasi 2 years pala kami dito, no, sa film festival. So yung effect ng first year, bago lang namin na distribute sa second year, no, tuloy-tuloy siya, so hindi pa namin nag-engage yun. But I believe it meron, kasi mga directors namin, example si Maricel, no, she's a daughter of a farmer, right? She's in the farm. She's from the farming, you know. Maybe mas mabuti siya mag-answer niya. Not really, no? Sige, please, Marcel. Explain mo ang film na nagawa mo at saan ka galing and everything you want to discuss.
Yes, good afternoon, everybody. So my film was on the first ToFarm, the title is Bulong ng Palay. And yes, I'm a daughter of a farmer, and the story was my story when I was growing up. Actually, up to now, we are still farmers, so we plant our own food, even the gulay. I have so many gulays right now. In terms of the question, the impact on the farmers right now, so I want to tell everybody that I asked permission actually from them, from Mom House or Shiny, that to show my film in Isabela, and at the same time I'm doing free filmmaking workshop at schools. And every time I show the film there, the kids are crying. So this is real. I mean, so now they realize how hard it is really to become a farmer, and they appreciate every bit, everything that they have now. And I think it's making a great impact ko. Sa totoo lang. Kasi, ewan ko, tinanong ko actually after the screening, so alam ko mas gusto yung pelikula, yung itong Kamangpalay or yung Ganda Rabido. And they said, itong Kamangpalay! Well, it's, sorry pa, pero it's really because of the lessons that they are learning through the films. That is also the advocacy of my power. So I'm still continuing to show the film. Yes, ma'am.
Are the children of farmers?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So the change in their attitude, Fanny, is very evident.
Definitely, ma'am.
I need a quote. I need a nice quote.
Sabi mo, sabi mo, yung mga winning niya kasi para makita mo, yung para ma-focus natin doon, no? Yung mga, yung sa mga katagalo ni Marcel, sa mga, yung kasi pambata yung kanya, eh, no? So, especially sa China,
yes, diba? I want to tell you a story. When it was shown in Japan and we won the Golden Owl Award as the grand prize, it's a women's fest. They really appreciated the film, the Japanese people. And when we showed it in China last November, it was really overwhelming because the Chinese people that watched the film, they were crying at the end and they were asking me how come I made this film, and they are really relating to the story. And true enough, I got a distribution in China. Yes, so they are writing the film. That's what I'm doing now. And they want to show the film in the cinemas as well. They are in China, so they just need to have a license from the government. And they also want to do a collaboration with me. And I told already Mom Hao about that. So it's really, well, it's all from Mom Hao from the ToFarm. So I wouldn't be able to do all of these things without the ToFarm and the hospital.
You come from a family of farmers. How many generations?
For as long as I can remember.
Oh, okay. And was your movie a happy movie or a sad movie?
It's a sad ending, but it's a life, you know.
Happy ending. Sad, but a happy ending.
Well, you have to watch it now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Dr. Lau. I want to find out how do you make this film successful to the farmers and what happened in Montreal? Because the movies are going to the movies is quite expensive.
What, well, we showed this in the provinces. We showed them we went around the country to promote these films. So may mga nag-meet sa amin mga areas, mga farmers actually, different regions in the Philippines, and we showed this.
Subsidized
ticket prices.
So they still have to pay.
Or is it the local government? No, see, we are in the theater, you know. See, in the best venue. But lately, I got a few LED screens, and I plan to have the LED screens in many places in the government, in the municipalities to show this kasi kung di papalabas yung mga pelikula namin sa sinihan, di papalabas sa ibang lugar. So we're going to have LED screens which are already arrived, and we will start, actually the Christians want to install them already. Hindi pa ako. Bibili kami ng lugar na pwede namin ipapalabas yung mga screens. Maybe
sir, which is also why the challenge actually of pushing for the success of advocacy films like the ones being produced under the ToFarm banner is only for the shoulders of Dr. Hao or people who are in the festival community, but to everybody. That's why we have press conferences, we have events like this, because we have to also remember always that we're not primarily an agricultural country. So the push must also come from all of us.
Gusto akong dagdagin, you know, the first 2 years na nandiyan si Direk Mario, actually, I was relying almost 100% on him. Kasi wala ko masasabi, siya lang nagdagdagin. So I asked him, actually, this is how it started. We met Direk Mario a little over two years ago, mga 2.5 years ago. And I told him, Direk, ako na mag-guide sa akin to do movies for the farm. No? So he immediately accepted the role. No? And we had a very good relationship together for the rest of the, you know, the rest of the 2 years, the ToFarm festival, you know, during the making. So I was just observing. I was always in the meeting, of course. I'm always participating, but siya yung nag-guide kasi hindi naman ako pwede makialam, no? Now that he's gone, now I've got two directors, very experienced director, so to guide me, continue to guide me. Now I'm already. I feel that I have to get out of my, of my cocoon. I have now to start to flex my wings, and now I'm trying to learn. Hindi naman talaga ang bala ko eh. So nakita naman ninyo, first 2 years, binining lang kami, marami na kami mga films na maraming awards. Now, ito mga coming years, we expect to do much, much better. So, I think the best part of our ToFarm years are still to come. So, I look forward to that.
Ang tanong lang po ako kay Dr. Hao. Good afternoon po, Dr. Hal. Dr. Hal, si Lorden Bonilla po, ako reporter ng Filipino Star ngayon. Yung sa bagong generation ngayon, medyo yung agriculture eh, medyo hindi na ano yung isang mga kabataan. Ngayon, sa inyong advocacy-a, ang tanong ko po, paano niyo po ma-influensyahan o paano niyo maihimo yung mga kabataan, lalo na yung millennials, sa inyong advocacy-a kung gaano ka-importante ng agrikultura?
Ang film is one medium to tell them, to show them the importance of agriculture. Actually, we do other work also, you know. So, how did the ToFarm Film Festival come about? It came from the ToFarm. The ToFarm is the search and award for outstanding farmers. That is our mother advocacy. That has been in existence for the past around 7 years or 8 years. So we annually have a search and award for outstanding farmers. That is purely farmers ang mga ano namin, ang mga guests namin. This goes a search and award for outstanding farmers all over the country. In the past, we had a SALCO collaboration with JCI Philippines. Kasi ang JCI Philippines, Junior Chamber International at Philippines, no? Marami silang chapters all over the country, sila nagsusupport. Sila ang kapatan namin, pangalam ng mga farmers. So, tumituloy yun every year then. Kami this year, we're going to have that again. It's a very noble advocacy. We have around 12 or 13 categories of winners. So, iba-ibang klase ng winners yan. Merong movement farmer, merong innovation farmer, merong GU sa farming. Maybe we like to invite you one time para makita nyo. Yun talagang poor farmers na. It's a very, very noble advocacy na pinapromote namin na maging mas magaling sila sa kanilang mga ginagawa. Magkatanim, kanilang innovation, meron din young farmer. If you'd like to know that, we can give you a list of na mga ano namin, nominations yan. So, Sunny? Wala si Sunny. Okay. I'd like to give you a name later. We'll tell you more about it. So, yung ToFarm na yun, yun ang pinagalingan ng inspiration ng ToFarm Film Festival. So, because of our work, advocacy sa mga growth and success ng farmers in our country, nagkaroon kami na na-inspire ako magkaroon ng ToFarm Film Festival para ipakita sa mga tao ang mga ginagawa ng mga farmers. Okay, wala akong parang napakita sa kanila. So, yan to. At marami pa kaming ginagawa na nalaman ninyo last week meron kaming press conference about another isang klaseng tulong sa mga farmers ng Panawi Ibugao. Yan din, connected din. Yan ang nagsanga na yung